Between 1994 and 1996, Elliott Smith's career took a sudden rise. Originally a songwriter, guitarist, and vocalist for Portland rock band Heatmiser, known for their aggressive songs rooted in grunge, post-hardcore, and noise rock, he released his first two solo albums, Roman Candle and the self-titled Elliott Smith, in 1994 and 1995 respectively. These albums marked a shift in tone for his songwriting, as the tracks were lo-fi, hushed, and acoustic, filled to the brim with vulnerable and often melancholic lyrical themes. Smith's unique brand of guitar playing and songwriting caught the eyes of several independent labels before he signed with Kill Rock Stars in 1995 for the release of the self-titled album, causing tensions in Heatmiser due to the sudden success Elliott was receiving, on top of his commitments to his solo tours compared to the band's. As a result, Heatmiser disbanded and released their final album Mike City Sons the following year, and soon, Elliott was back to recording solo material. The product of several sessions across 1996, recorded in numerous locations with different producers, Either Or was released on February 25, 1997, and has since become Elliott Smith's defining work, for its lush yet lo-fi sound, the perfected display of his songwriting abilities, for its seemingly effortless segue towards brighter, more expansive work soon to come, and as an unplanned yet formally fitting send-off to the life that he lived in Portland, as he would begin a new chapter of life after its release. Today, we're going to take a look at it. For the unaware, I have been an Elliott Smith fan for 4 years now. By that, I mean I was a fan for 3 years, and then turned into an unstoppably obsessed superfan last year. To say that Elliott Smith is one of my favorite artists of all time is an understatement, and it is probably just as likely that he ties as my favorite with Liz Phair and Tool. His work has touched me in places that no other artist has ever been able to, my life has been saved by lots of his music, and I have found myself immersed in his world of emotionally potent rock and folk more times than I can count. This is the album that started it all for me, back in 2017. Shortly after my foray into indie began, I started noticing the name Elliott Smith thrown around in random places where I discovered music. I was immediately intrigued, but I don't quite remember why. I quickly moved to hear the album, and to say my mind was blown wouldn't do the experience justice. It's funny, because I hardly remember the full experience of hearing this album for the first time, but the songs Between the Bars, Pictures of Me, and Say Yes stayed in my rotation for months to come. Unfortunately, this was most of my experience with Elliott for a long time, and it wasn't until 2019 that I furthered my experience in his work, and properly reevaluated Either Or itself and refined my opinions on it. And it wasn't until early in 2020 that I truly devoted a ton of energy to his work. Nevertheless, Either Or is likely his most enduring album, even if it isn't my favorite, and I'd like to give it the proper attention it deserves. I made the realization yesterday that I have never made a video on Elliott Smith before, and what better album to start off with than his most beloved? Let's dive right in and not waste any more time. I apologize if my words here cannot do this album justice, but I'm gonna try my best. There is a lot I'd like to discuss about this album, and I don't even know if I'll get to all of it. Some of it related to its recording, some of it related to the music itself, and some of it even about my own personal experiences with it. To start with the recording, Either Or was recorded at multiple homes, multiple studios, and in two different states, such as in Elliott's current girlfriend Joanna Bohm's house, his own home, and in studios with producers like Larry Crane, Tom Rothrock, and Rob Schnopf. The sessions were plentiful, and the 12 songs that make up Either Or's running order are only the tip of the iceberg, which I'll get into later. Despite the constantly shifting locations and the copious amounts of quote-unquote sessions in which we could group the songs, there seems to be a continuous tone and quality to the recordings themselves, as if they were all done in one go in one place. Considering the lo-fi foundations of his first two albums, it's no surprise that Either Or retains much of the same production qualities, but at points there is a very distinct clarity that breaks through. In tandem with this often intimate yet expansive sound, Elliott's lyrics are at their most reflective on Either Or. This becomes immediately obvious from the very first verse of album opener Speed Trials, the lyrics of which are nearly whispered in a melancholic haze of hushed vocals, bare-bones guitar, and an almost ambient drum quietly clanging away in the background. You can almost immerse yourself in the cold, vivid imagery that he lays out on this song, and the same goes for much of this album's songs. His words are doused in self-doubt, dreary urban decay, bitter acceptance, flashes of seething anger, anxiety, isolation, and negative dependence, among other things, across the entirety of Either Or. In songs like Punch and Judy, he, to me, draws a picture of a city at night with the music itself, as the song's morally ambiguous characters rely on attention and inclusion, before switching to a perspective in which Elliott himself seems to lament his dissatisfaction with Portland, a place he'd been calling home for almost a decade at this point. In a way, one could say that Either Or and its lyricism are a full realization and combination of the themes explored on Roman Candle and Self-Titled in much more digestible doses, in ways that are more intensely relatable, and without being too passionately heartbreaking. If Roman Candle is defined by depressive anger, and the self-titled album defined by unfiltered, raw desolation, Either Or is a diluted mix of the two, on top of the aforementioned reflective nature of much of the album's lyrics. While one could say that the self-titled album is Elliott Smith's darkest hour, and I would certainly push that notion, Either Or is his most downtrodden, depressive, and sad. In relation to the album's reflective qualities, songs like Rose Parade in particular feel like a stabbing portrayal of depression and the mundanities that often follow it. Inspired by the real-life Rose Festival that takes place every year in Portland, Elliott paints a picture of a friend dragging the obviously uninterested protagonist, presumably Elliott himself, to join a bunch of people in a mood of jubilation and camaraderie, while he finds himself unenthused by the seemingly fake behavior that surrounds him. There's two lines in this song that particularly drive this point home as someone who struggles with social anxiety and depression myself, and those lines are, "Say it's a sign that's quite worth seeing. It's just that everyone's interest is stronger. Incredibly poignant, and one of those musical moments that hits me when I least expect it. On the more intimate side of things, we have the inimitable and iconic Between the Bars, one of Elliott Smith's most acclaimed and well-known songs, and for good reason. It was one of a handful of his songs that was included in Gus Van Sant's 1997 film Good Will Hunting, and its lyrics paint an incredibly painful picture. Sounding like the audible equivalent of a 3 a.m. emotional bender, full of lost thoughts, things you wish you could have done better, and the aforementioned themes of negative dependence, seemingly represented here by the vice of alcohol. A story of regret, fear, and helplessness, Elliott has penned one of his bleakest but also most relatable songs with Between the Bars. Words cannot even begin to describe what the song means to me, the importance it had in furthering my love of Elliott's work, and the amount of nights that it has soundtracked, even on good days. Equally as intimate, but nowhere near as crushingly bleak, Angelus is a beautiful sounding cut that I see as having two meanings. The most generally accepted is Elliott's apprehension towards the music industry that he was slowly immersing himself in, sending out flaming critiques of music industry bigheads in the first line, and painting the industry as a corruptive entity, hell-bent on wringing every last drop of creativity and commerciality out of every artist it comes across. Which, you know, isn't too far off. However, I have sort of thought of this song as an almost romantic song in my head. One with some self-hating jabs, particularly in the third verse. Knowing Elliott's more romantic songs, if you can call them that, that contain similarly self-loathing lyrics, such as possibly my favorite song of his, Satellite, I tend to stand by this. However, I understand that this is a complete reach, and is not at all what the song is about. But the delivery and standing of those lines in particular give me a compulsion to perceive it that way. I'd really like to talk about every track on this album in depth, but I doubt I'll be able to do that without making this video extremely long, more than it already is. I'd like to focus on three more, Pictures of Me, 2:45 a.m., and Say Yes. If there's any songs otherwise that you'd like to hear my more in-depth opinions on, let me know in the comments and I'll do my best to sum up my thoughts for you. To start with Pictures of Me, this is the song that made me a fan of Elliott Smith. Its energetic, loud sound caught my ear immediately, combined with his rallying vocals, jumping between clenched teeth anger, quiet and unwavering coolness, and cautionary warnings. Musically, it is the fullest song on Either Or, and the biggest hint towards his work on future albums like XO and Figure 8. At the same time, I also think it's the brightest song on Either Or, but not the most optimistic. On the flip side of this brightness, 2:45 a.m. likely deals with one of Elliott Smith's most harrowing lyrical topics, suicidal ideation. Smith had a history of suicidal thoughts, especially throughout the 1990s, and friends of his in Portland would later reflect on how they would often check up on him and spend the night with him to make sure he didn't do anything rash. The lyrics in the song's third verse, which I'll put on screen right now, seem to carry a much more haunting meaning when you take into consideration that, while on tour for Either Or in North Carolina, Elliott attempted suicide by running off a cliff while drunk before a tree was able to break his fall. It is one in a series of heartbreakingly tragic events that plagued the later years of his life, but that discussion is not meant for here or there right now. To turn towards something a bit more uplifting, we come to the album's final song, Say Yes. Described by Elliott as an insanely optimistic song that was written in just 5 minutes, Say Yes is unlike Elliott's past closing tracks, which often painted an ambiguous or emotionally shattering portrait. It is certainly the happiest song in Elliott's early work, and especially on Either Or, considering the emotional roller coaster that the songs before it take the listener on. I'd liken it to something like the final untitled track on The Cure's Disintegration, in which the tone of the song seems initially ambiguous or dark and sad, but the songwriter himself has revealed the true meaning behind its words. Working perfectly as an act of catharsis at the very end of this 36-minute journey, Say Yes is without a doubt one of Elliott Smith's best songs and one of his most triumphant. As I stated before, there were copious amounts of songs written and recorded during the sessions for Either Or, many of which were shelved and eventually released on the 2007 archival album New Moon. While I'd like to save my formal opinions and in-depth explanation for the inevitable review I will do for that album, two of the songs, I think, should have ended up on this album one way or another. Going Nowhere and Pretty Mary Kay Other Version, two songs that I believe rank among the highest of Smith's entire catalog. As fate would have it, the aftermath of Either Or's release caused a massive shift in Elliott Smith's life. As mentioned previously, Gus Van Sant used a handful of Smith's songs in Good Will Hunting, including Either Or outtake Miss Misery, one of his most famous songs as a result. The song was notably nominated for an Oscar in 1998, which Smith performed at the ceremony, but lost to Celine Dion for My Heart Will Go On from Titanic. The success of Good Will Hunting and the presence of Elliott Smith on its soundtrack got the attention of numerous major labels, particularly DreamWorks, with whom Elliott signed in early 1998, and he released his fourth and fifth albums, XO and Figure 8, on the label. This is a very abridged version of the events that took place here following Either Or's release, and I left out plenty of details. I just think this is the basic aftermath that deserves an absolute mention. All in all, Either Or remains Elliott Smith's most iconic and well-known album, attracting new fans all the time and keeping his most indulged fans company during their darkest moments. In a way, Elliott told his own life story on the first three records that he released, but none of the tracks in these batches come close to the mature-for-his-age tone in Either Or's execution. With this album, Elliott Smith was cemented as a champion of modern songwriters, expanded his low-key reputation out of Portland, and became a defining indie musician of the 1990s. And of all time. There are droves of modern-day singer-songwriters that owe most of their inspiration to Elliott himself, and especially this album. Again, to state what Either Or means to me as both an album and an emotional experience is nearly impossible to put into words. It is an album that is meant to be experienced. I implore you, if you have not heard this album before watching this video, please, please do yourself a favor and check it out. It demands your attention, your respect, and your emotional vulnerability. Either Or is ranked as one of my essential albums, currently sitting at number 23 on my top albums of all time. With that, I give Elliott Smith's Either Or a 10 out of 10.